next guests have turned the Clintons into comic book villains, kinda.
The many scandals surrounding Bill and Hillary Clinton laid out in the book Clinton Cash is now packed into a new graphic novel.
Joining us right now is Peter Schweitzer. He's the author of Clinton Cash, the untold story of how foreign governments and businesses made Bill and Hillary rich. And Brett Smith, standing right next to him, he's the creative director behind Clinton Cash, a graphic novel. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning. Good morning.
Graphic novel, we used to call those comic books, right?
That's true. That's very true.
So. What happened?
Well, they're not printed in newsprint anymore, and they're a little more sophisticated, printed on nicer paper. We have a hardcover on this book as well, so it's a sophisticated comic.
All right, so Peter, which cover do you like more, this cover of Clinton Cash or the original one when the book came out?
Well, I tell you, I think they did a great job, the artist. This is sort of the Brewster's Millions, you know, that movie that came out. I think this is sort of the rendition of that. I think it's fabulous. I think what's so interesting for me is this is kind of a cultural shift. I mean, I'm an investigative journalist. I write nonfiction books. And when they first came to me with this idea, I thought, how is that going to work? You take journalism and you create something like this, but they did a fabulous job turning it into a narrative story, making it accessible to people.
So, Brett, let's talk about this panel on Podium Economics, deposits only. There's Bill Clinton right there. He's handing in some Benjamins to this person. What are you trying to say there?
Well, he's taking a deposit, actually.
Oh, he's taking the money.
Right. He's taking a deposit, and we have tin horn dictators and, you know, horrible despots in the background who are all making deposits.
All donors to the Clinton Foundation.
And the Clinton Global Initiative, exactly.
According to that man's book.
Right. I mean, what's so interesting is, it's, you know, it's follow the money. It's the old story of follow the money. And I think what this graphic novel does is it conveys it in a way that makes it accessible to people who maybe don't have the time to sit down and read a serious nonfiction book. I think millennials love this sort of approach because it's humorous. They put in humor and a lot of great visual images.
Yeah, there's some good humor in this panel as well. We've got Ronald Reagan here, George H.W. Bush, and then down here, Bill Clinton.
Yeah, they're talking about the fact that ex-presidents since Eisenhower have all hit the lecture circuit, but nobody has done it in the manner that Bill Clinton has. The fact that his wife was first a senator and then Secretary of State. So I guess it was conveying with the Podium Economics panel in the middle. You know, there's this problem of, are these really speaking fees or are these deposits and attempts to affect, bribe, or gain access to the Clintons through these speaking fees?
Sure. Brent, you know, there's a lot of curveballs in this particular story because it's not, you know, Exhibit A, ladies and gentlemen. You got to connect some of the dots.
Right.
That's got to be daunting for you to try to figure out how to put it on a panel, you know, expertly.
We had fantastic talent on this book. We had Chuck Dixon, who has over 40 years experience at Marvel in D.C., and he helped bring it together along with the artists. It's taking this book and turning it into visual storytelling.
Okay, Peter, I've got to ask you about the blockbuster story. We had Tom Fenton from Judicial Watch. You know, we'll walk a little so you can come on. We had Tom Fenton on from Judicial Watch. They got about 300 new pages that show essentially these were emailed that nobody had seen before. Apparently,
right.
They got them from Huma Abedin. It looks like if you wanted influence at the State Department, just give cash to the Clinton Foundation.
What we have going on right here.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And Tom Fitton and Judicial Watch, they just do fantastic work. And there's a lot of emails now that indicate that if you were a major Clinton Foundation donor, a guy like Gilbert Chigori, for example, that you gain access to the State Department. And if you're a foreign businessman or a foreign despot, you want to be on good terms with America's chief diplomat, and the way to do that is pay Bill to give a speech or donate to the Clinton Foundation.
Yeah, and somebody donated $1 million, wound up getting a job on the International Security Advisory Board, even though he had no experience in the field.
Yeah, exactly.
Wasn't there a song about money changes everything?
That's exactly right.
Pay to play, that's right.
That's right.
Brett, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Brett,
thanks a lot.
Thanks, guys.
Awesome.
Peter.
Cool.
Check it out, the graphic novel.
There you go.
Time for the After the Show show. Leland, you want to stick around?
I don't know. Is there room?
Yeah, absolutely.
Sure.
We have got on the couch. You know,
you know the
first guy right here?
Yeah. Hey, good to see you.
How you been?
Good.
Somewhere to go.
Oh,
I have nowhere to go. Trust me. So, Ains
convince me to sit down next to her, yet I have something more important.
So Peter Schweitzer wrote the New York Times bestseller, actually everybody's bestseller, Clinton Cash, and Brett Smith is the creative director of this graphic novel called Clinton Cash, and essentially it's the good stuff from your book in comic book form.
That's right. That's right. And these are world-class artists. I mean, they did Batman, they've done Simpsons, they've done a whole host of them, and they just did an amazing job on
it. He opened it up to Hillary Clinton in like a rapper's outfit, the big gold necklace, yes. The money necklace hanging from her neck.
Yeah.
What's going on in that one?
They're rapping about the Keystone Pipeline in that one, and that was actually something that we had to take something out and replace it with something else, and it was one of those happy accidents where what we originally had was funny, but what we ended up having to change it into in order to make it work was even funnier. And Chuck and I came up with that, I think, like one day. We were sitting there, okay, how do we replace this frame? We got to take it out.
That is
and,
really funny.
He said, let's turn it into 80s rappers. And I said, well, make someone put a clock or something around your neck, like Flip and Flav.
I think I went to a date party in my fraternity once dressed like that. I could be wrong. But I'm pretty sure there's a picture somewhere. You know, I've read Gold Chain. Yeah, it was
nice. I've read Clinton Cash. There's nothing funny about it. I'm just saying, it's tragic if true.
Yeah, no. Well, that's the funny part. When they first approached me, I thought, how is this going to work? I mean, how are you going to make it? It's just going to be all doom and gloom. And there are parts, you know, on the Haiti reconstruction and the terrible things, which really there's no humor in Haiti, so to speak. But they said, no, look, I mean, you've got to give a little bit of humor there because it is so serious. Yeah. It can be so sort of heavy. And I think they have a great mix. So you see Bill and Hillary in kind of a whole new light, but in a way that's consistent with what
you said. It's also a little more approachable, too. And yeah. I think we should know on Facebook Live right now, yeah. all of us. So if people have questions, serious questions about the Clinton and Cash and the email scandal that just broke as well, you can type in and eventually will make their way to us.
People are doing that right now, Peter. We're being told by our producers that overwhelmingly people are asking, when is she going to be prosecuted, if ever?
Well, that's a good
Both
question.
Both of you rolling your eyes. Like, what's it going to take is what they're asking.
I think, look, I mean, when you look at prosecutions in America, you know, Senator Menendez or Governor McDonald in Virginia, they're political in nature. You want to think that they're just looking at the crime and they're weighing the evidence, but a prosecutor or an FBI that is investigating somebody has to look at the consequences. Right. And when you're taking on powerful people like the Clintons, you know, it works in their favor. What I find ironic is, you know, Hillary Clinton made this statement on 60 Minutes that she thinks there's a double standard.
Yeah, right.
That sometimes it works against
There is a double standard.
Exactly, but she thinks it works against her. Well, I think it actually works in her favor.
Well, today on the cover of the New York Post, there's something that's right up your alley. Shocking emails reveal Hill sells U.S. out. These are some State Department emails that have been discovered. Apparently, Judicial Watch has been pestering the State Department. They finally got them. Judicial Watch gets all these things that the congressional committees don't because the White House feels, you know, they're political, we're going to stonewall them. And they have.
That's right. And guys like Tom Fitton, Citizens United does the same thing where they litigate. And eventually, it may take 3 or 4 years, the material comes out. And this is sort of a classic story. What it shows is that Gilbert Chigori, who's pledged $1 billion to the Clinton Global Initiative.
That opens a lot of doors, $1 billion.
I would think, anything that starts with a letter B in terms of money is going to open doors. And Gilbert Chigori has a very sketchy record, to say the least. And he's been charged and convicted on money laundering, aiding and abetting a criminal enterprise. He's a Nigerian businessman. And we now have emails that say, you know, look, he wants help dealing with matters in Lebanon. He's of Lebanese background. Open doors for him. So that's essentially what happened. He's not a American. He lives in Nigeria. And yet he gets this kind of access.
Well, we talked to Rudy Giuliani earlier on the show, 8 o'clock. He came on and said that as a former federal prosecutor, which he was, certainly a very effective one, he said there is more than enough here for an investigation and indictment, just in these emails, not to mention all the other things that we saw.
No, I think that's a great point. And look, I am certainly not Rudy Giuliani. I'm not an attorney or anything, but having looked at the pattern of evidence against the Clintons, against Senator Menendez in New Jersey, who's being prosecuted, the former governor of Alabama, Seligman, the former governor of Virginia, McDonald, to me, the evidence in the Clinton case is so much stronger.
The stakes are so much higher,
exactly.
Too. Bob McDonald introduced some guy who had a vitamin business, not talking about, Lebanon, a few other U.S. major U.S. interests around the world.
Right, and ultimately, the U.S. Supreme Court said what he did was not extraordinary.
That's exactly
right. And so he's off the hook.
Yeah, I would say what the Clintons have done done is extraordinary. When you look at the policy decisions that were reversed or the changes that were made for the benefit of Clinton donors, it's not like McDonald who had set up meetings, right, which is kind of what a governor does, yeah, for people. These were specific favors done for the benefit
of quid pro cash.
Yes.
And think about the dollar values. McDonald, $150,000 over the whole time.
Right.
Menendez, a few flights on a private jet over years. Clinton would get $150,000 for one speech on one day.
That's true. Yes. So we've asked a lot of people on Facebook to weigh in and to talk to both of you. And Robert on Facebook is asking you guys, how many people do you think were looking for favors for cash?
All of them.
That's how it works. Yeah. The biggest thing for me in the book is not only Haiti, but also the uranium. Selling out the U.S. is with 20% of the uranium, yeah, to the Russians, just as nine Russian investors are donating, was it $150 million to the...
Yeah.
To
that's the such a good story about the uranium. Explain that for our viewers. Well, here on Facebook Live. Hello, Facebook.
Exactly. Hello on Facebook.
It's the most time I've spent on Facebook in years.
Yeah.
You're making a grave mistake. It's wonderful. I love Facebook. Facebook is great.
It's really a pretty amazing story because we think of corruption in the State Department about, you know, the ambassador to Botswana becomes a donor. In this case, it's uranium in the ground in the U.S. And you have this Canadian investor, Frank Giustra, who's given a lot of money to the Clinton Foundation. The Clintons helped him secure these uranium deposits in, right, Kazakhstan. Then he started buying uranium in the United States. He wanted to sell the uranium to the Russian government.
Right.
What could go wrong with that, right?
Our uranium sold to the Russians.
Yes, exactly, to Rosatom, which is the Russian state, yeah, nuclear agency.
But, and what, but it's Trump who's in bed with the Russians.
Right, that's what I've heard. You know? So what happened?
So what happened was this deal to go down has to be approved by several government agencies, including the State Department.
Cozy.
And
did she approve it?
She did. Now, right before that, eight shareholders in this small Canadian company had this spontaneous outpouring of philanthropy. They decided to give $145 million to the Clinton Foundation.
Wow.
They did.
And tell the viewers what the uranium can be used for. Why this is so significant.
Yeah, well, that's exactly right.
Only.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's
for nuclear weapons.
Yes, right. It goes boom or you know, civilian nuclear technology. And one of the troubling things that the New York Times reported in the follow-up is that part of the deal is when the Russians bought this, they could not export the uranium out of the United States. Well, guess what? The New York Times confirmed the uranium now is being exported out of the United States.
So does that mean if we sell our uranium to another country?
No, it's not our uranium.
Yeah.
It's theirs.
It's the Russians' uranium.
Now it is, but it was ours. If we sell that to Russia, if they make a bomb to blow us up, who's at fault?
Well, that's a great question, and that's exactly right. And that's the scary thing. They said, don't worry about this deal because we're going to make sure that none of the uranium gets exported. Well, the New York Times confirmed that yellow cake, you know, we've heard of yellow cake.
Joe Wilson.
Yeah, exactly. Nigeria. Joe Wilson. That yellow cake has been exported, and we don't actually know where it's ending up. So it's not at all inconceivable that this could end up in Russia, it could end up in Iran, who knows where.
The Russians don't exactly have a great history with securing nuclear weapons or nuclear material.
We've got some more questions.
Does that make Hillary complicit, though?
I think it does. I mean, look, the security implications, they got State Department cables when she was Secretary of State warning that the Russians were trying to corner the uranium market, and they ignored it.
We have the best viewers. We have the best viewers. We always ask you guys to donate to charities or to have conversations with us on social media, and Glory is doing that.
Yep.
Glory is asking you guys, justice is supposed to be blind. The same standards should apply to all citizens. Why is this not enforced?
I think she's exactly right. I think this is one of the key frustrations that people have in American politics today. There was a survey done, I think it was by Gallup a few months ago, asked them what they thought about Washington, D.C., and 75% of the American people believe that widespread corruption takes place in the nation's capital. I think this is part of the reason. They think that there's a double standard, that political figures, certain political figures, can get away with behaviors that others can't.
Just
and that's the cynicism.
Look at James Comey and Hillary and all that. By the way, all of our viewers who are weighing in are thanking you for your shoeless work on this particular project.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
Both of you, actually.
It's a lot of work.
And a great result. And there's a level of understanding that, you know, for kids and folks in
whole
high school and everything else,
yes,
that now all of a sudden can understand this rather than reading an in-depth investigative book. There's a great understanding that comes to this.
You know, or if you don't have the time or maybe the fortitude to make it through the original 198 pages.
It can be explained with rappers wearing gold chains. Job well
thank
done.
You guys.
so much.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Nice to see you again.
Thanks for joining us on Facebook Live.
Thank you, and thanks for watching us. He did a great job.